Church. This is the first Markdale Community Christmas Choir concert since 2019. The choir is happy to be here, to be able to return to live music, weekly rehearsals, and of course to bring you this evening of entertainment. I have two brief announcements to make. One is regarding safety. If there is a need to evacuate the building, there are exits upstairs, downstairs, and of course the way most of you came in. Number two, cell phones. Turn them off, please, so that we don't get some funny music in the middle of the concert. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Is a popular Christmas song written in 1963 by Edward Pola and George Weil. It was recorded and released that year by pop singer Andy Williams for his first Christmas album, the Andy Williams Christmas album. Nowadays, it has regained popularity as the jingle for Staples when kids are returning to school after being home all summer.
Thank you.
popular New Age singer, Enya, wrote her song, Amid the Falling Snow, in 2005. The liner notes tell us that it recalls the moment when you are first mesmerized by the falling snow as a child, remembering the wonder experienced as a child, particularly the magic of Christmastide. And there are those who, even as they grow older, are still able to experience the wonder of snow. Blues swing style, Amen, Tell It on the Mountain creatively combines two familiar spirituals, Amen and Go Tell It on the Mountain. There are many soulful blues notes in the piano part, and the accessible and catchy vocals build to an exciting finish.
Oh.
King Wenceslas. It's a Christmas carol that tells the story of a Bohemian king who goes on a journey, braving harsh winter weather, to give alms to a poor peasant on the feast of Stephen, December 25th, the second day of Christmas. During the journey, his page is about to give up the struggle against the cold weather, but is enabled to continue by following the king's footprints, step for step, through the deep snow. The legend is based on the life of the historical saint Wenceslas I, Duke of Bohemia, 907 to 935. In 1853, English hymn writer John Mason Neal wrote the Wenceslas lyrics. And the song has been a part of popular Christmas culture ever since. The spiritual opens with unison male voices and adds a female counter melody before expanding into full four-part harmony.
Born in Bethlehem, same time, he baby was but one child. Born in Bethlehem, hallelujah.
Bobby Helms released Jingle Bell Rock in 1957. I remember it well. I was in high school. It wasn't until 60 years later that the song finally entered the Billboard Hot 100 Top 10. In 1958, Brenda Lee released Rockin' Round the Christmas Tree and quickly became a Christmas classic. The medley arrangement by Doug Warner demonstrates how these two Christmas rock songs were made for each other. Intermission, composer Sally Albrecht has blended three songs together. Going on a Sleigh Ride shifts into a mix of Jingle Bells and Over the River before building to an exciting end.
Now it's now. taking about a 10-minute intermission, and then we have an intermission show for you as well. So we're welcome to that in that time. Enjoy your little break, and we'll see you in about 10 minutes.
Thank you.
now that everyone has had time to talk to everybody and tell them how great things are going, as the usual tradition at these concerts, we have some performances during the intermission by members of the choir. Choir member Connie Viljakainen and her son Justin have a performance. A Newfoundland twist on the song The 12 Days of Christmas by Terry Mulcrey. And our director, Bill Legate, will shift to playing his violin along with Elaine Mitchell on oboe.
Quando sei con me, so perché però sento già quel calore che mi accarezzare, mi sorride e mi porta da te. Se ami lui verrà, il dolore passerà, se ami sentirai che amare vero è.
Quando sei con me, sento l'anima, vedo la bellezza intorno.
Because they're wondering what to get their loved ones as gifts for Christmas. We have the solution. There's a new box store in town where you can buy anything you want. You can buy Uncle George the squid lines or lobster pots. You can buy Aunt Mame whatever she needs in the clothing direction. So all you got to do is go to this store. It's called Whale Mart. And that's the store that's got everything. So that's the paid announcement. Now let's get on with the singing. Would you? You don't have to breathe so hard. It's not that hard. I'll be nice on
you. You change it every time.
There's only 12 days and I can't count past 10 fingers, what you expect after the last year ago problem. Anyway, let's do it. On the first day of Christmas, my missus gave to me this black saw Easter storm hat for me. Now these are great in the storm. They're also good for hiding the ball. That men who are bald in the front, they're the tinkers. Those are the boys that tink. The boys that tink all the time. And men who are bald in the back, well, they're the lovers. And the men who are bald all over, they just tink, they're lovers. On the second day, Christmas ornaments, but a partridge berry is about the size of a cranberry or a little cherry, and if I was to show you that today, you'd go, I can't see it, but you can see these and use your imagination, partridge berry. Two partridge berries and this black sou'easter storm hat for me. On the third day of Christmas, my missus bought for me tree rubber boots. Now you need one more. She bought me this thing, it's called a fascinate sweater. Now, you may be fascinated because you look at it and say, oh, it's beautiful, it's blue, it's hand-knitted. It's got a beautiful fascinate crest on here. And to anybody that says it's a fascinate sweater, but here's what happens. You see, ladies and gentlemen, this is called a fascinate sweater, not because it's beautiful or because it's got a crest or it's blue handmade knitted. It's called a fascinate sweater because when my wife first used to make me sweaters, it had 10 buttons on it, right? But I could only fasten 8.
Me.
7 days of Christmas, my missus bought for me 7 pairs of long johns. Now, you know, at our age, and some of you men know this is true, when you get to be our age, you keep forgetting things. So my wife very kindly, when she made the 7 pairs of long johns, made them so I knew which the front was and which the back was. many a sleepless night trying to figure out what to play when I'm singing. And what's even worse, I spent many a sleepless night trying to sing when he's playing.
Some of us aren't quite so tall as Jim.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I want to give a few pieces of thanks here. First of all, I'd like to thank Jim today for being our MC. I really appreciate it. You do a wonderful job when you do this. I'd also like to thank, oh yeah, of course, thank you, Jim. I would also like to thank Ansel United Church for hosting us again. We really appreciate the space. It's a fantastic facility, incredible spot for us to be. And part of the church, of course, we would be remiss to not thank Patty Shaw, who works in the office and has done a great amount of work to get ready for this. And also Tim Riley, who's looked after our sound and our lights. And thank you so much for that tonight as well. Part of our behind-the-scenes group that you don't really see other than when they're singing, and they do a wonderful job. We have Vivian Tolton, who is kind of our den mother. She looks after all of our music, gets all of it organized, does such a wonderful job, and we're very appreciative of her. And also Nancy Edwards, she is the lady who makes sure that everybody knows where to go and what to do and when we're going to do it by sending all of her emails out and getting us organized. Thank you to those ladies. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Murray's Print Shop, who has done a great job on the flyer or on the bulletins that you're looking at today, and also to Dragonfly Designs. If you saw a poster around town about the concert, thanks to them. Also, a special thanks to our soloists and our accompanists, Connie and Justin Villiers-Canin, Terry Mokry, Elaine Mitchell, and most especially, of course, David Fries, who is the best accompanist going. He's just amazing. We thank you so much for everything, David. And also I'd like to thank James Samus, who last night we forgot to give him something. Unfortunately, he's moving to Ottawa next year, something I'm not entirely pleased with. Finally, I'd like to mention that donations tonight, it is a free will offering, and donations are in for the Canadian Cancer Society. This is in memory a little bit of my father, I guess, but also in recognition of our incredible conductor, get the words right, Legate, our conductor of the last 10 years. Chris Griffin. She is now changed spots with me and allowed me to wave my arms, and she's singing and doing an amazing job, and this is in recognition of Chris as well. So we welcome your donations today towards the Canadian Cancer Society. Please give freely, and thank you so much for that as well. Much appreciated. All right, we'll get started. Donations are at the end, there'll be baskets at the door. Please feel free to drop hundreds, 200s, 500s.
John Jacob Niles, 1892 to 1980, began collecting Appalachian folk songs and composing music as a Kentucky teenager. Jesus, Jesus, Rest Your Head is one of the Kentucky folk carols he adapted. Comes from the well-known musical and movie, The Sound of Music. This song famously appears in a scene in the film when the Von Trapp children she looks after are frightened and go to her room during a thunderstorm, and she sings it to comfort them.
Hallelujah.
In Moonlight Sleigh Ride, composing partners Nancy Price and Dan Bessig combine musical styles to create an exciting adventure on a winter's night. Many churches produce a Christmas pageant in which there are three wise men dressed as kings delivering gifts to the baby Jesus. The hymn, We Three Kings, may be the primary reason for this tradition. John Henry Hopkins Jr. first published this song in 1863.
Oh.
point, something has happened. If you come to a few of our concerts, you may have seen this before. We have a guest conductor who's going to do some conducting for us and to do our MC. So Austin, would you like to take the baton? Sure. Come on up.
We now invite the audience to join us in singing some Christmas carols. You will find these songs in your bulletin. David is getting faster in his old age. I didn't think he would be there yet. And afterwards, after the carol singing, David will open up the organ as he plays the Hallelujah Chorus from Handel's Messiah. Now, unlike King George, when it was first premiered, he thought it was over and he stood up. And so everybody, of course, stood up when the king stood up. And ever since then, when the Hallelujah Chorus is sung, the audience always stands. Please remain seated tonight.
So it's your turn to be the choir. We're going to start off with Jingle Bells. And I expect to hear a lot of sound. Because I'm going to produce a lot of sound, you have to sing above that.
Thank you.
sing next year already.
We're going to be singing Jingle Bell Rock once again for you, just because I like Jingle Bell Rock. And if you'd like to sing along while we're singing it, please feel free to do so.
The final song for the evening is another piece written by Sally Albrecht. God Bless Us, Everyone, reminds us of the reason for the season. We hope you've enjoyed this return to live music. I know the choir is excited to be able to bring this Christmas choir back to the community. You all had your audition for next year when the carols sing. If you're interested in joining the choir next September, please look for the Facebook group and let Bill know.